Second Chronicles Chapter 24, Judah's King Joash. Joash was 7 years old when he became king and reigned 40 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Zibiah. She was from Beersheba. Throughout the time of Jehoiada the priest, Joash did what was right in the Lord's sight. Jehoiada acquired 2 wives for him, and he was the father of sons and daughters. Repairing the temple. Afterward, Joash took it to heart to renovate the Lord's temple, so he gathered the priests and Levites and said, "Go out to the cities of Judah and collect money from all Israel to repair the temple of your God as needed year by year, and do it quickly." However, the Levites did not hurry, so the king called Jehoiada the high priest and said, "Why haven't you required the Levites to bring from Judah and Jerusalem the tax imposed by the Lord's servant Moses and the assembly of Israel for the tent of the testimony?" For the sons of that wicked Athaliah broke into the Lord's temple and even used the sacred things of the Lord's temple for the bowels. At the king's command, a chest was made and placed outside the gate of the Lord's temple. Then a proclamation was issued in Judah and Jerusalem that the tax God's servant Moses imposed on Israel in the wilderness be brought to the Lord. All the leaders and all the people rejoiced, brought the tax, and put it in the chest until it was full. Whenever the chest was brought by the Levites to the king's overseers, and when they saw that there was a large amount of money, the king's secretary and the high priest's deputy came and emptied the chest, picked it up, and returned it to its place. They did this daily and gathered the money in abundance. Then the king and Jehoiada gave it to those in charge of the labor on the Lord's temple, who were hiring stone cutters and carpenters to renovate the Lord's temple, also blacksmiths and coppersmiths to repair the Lord's temple. The workmen did their work, and through them the repairs progressed. They restored God's temple to its specifications and reinforced it. When they finished, they presented the rest of the money to the king and Jehoiada, who made articles for the Lord's temple with it, articles for ministry and for making burnt offerings and ladles and articles of gold and silver. They regularly offered burnt offerings in the Lord's temple throughout Jehoiada's life. Joash's apostasy. Jehoiada died when he was old and full of days. He was 130 years old at his death. He was buried in the city of David with the kings because he had done what was good in Israel with respect to God and his temple. However, after Jehoiada died, the rulers of Judah came and paid homage to the king. Then the king listened to them, and they abandoned the temple of the Lord, the God of their ancestors, and served the Asherah poles and the idols. So there was wrath against Judah and Jerusalem for this guilt of theirs. Nevertheless, he sent them prophets to bring them back to the Lord. They had admonished them, but the people would not listen. The Spirit of God took control of Zechariah, son of Jehoiada the priest. He stood above the people and said to them, "This is what God says. Why are you transgressing the Lord's commands, and you do not prosper? Because you have abandoned the Lord, he has abandoned you." But they conspired against him and stoned him at the king's command in the courtyard of the temple, Lord's temple. King Joash did not remember the kindness that Zechariah's father Jehoiada had extended to him, but killed his son. While he was dying, he said, "May the Lord see and demand an account." Aramean invasion of Judah. At the turn of the year, an Aramean army went to war against Joash. They entered Judah and Jerusalem and destroyed all the leaders of the people among them and sent all the plunder to the king of Damascus. Although the Aramean army came with only a few men, the Lord handed over a vast army to them because the people of Judah had abandoned the Lord, the God of their ancestors. So they executed judgment on Joash. Joash assassinated. When the Arameans saw that Joash had many wounds, they left him. His servants conspired against him and killed him on his bed, because he had shed the blood of the sons of Jehoiada the priest. So he died, and they buried him in the city of David, but they did not bury him in the tombs of the kings. Those who conspired against him were Zabad, son of Ammonite woman Shemiath, and Jehozabad, son of the Moabite woman Shimrith. Concerning his sons, the many oracles about him, and the restoration of the Lord's temple, they are recorded in the writing of the Book of the Kings. His son Amaziah became king in his place.